Your Royal Majesty Oboro Baran the Second, Archetype Agadaba, the Emperor of Barmot Kingdom, and your brother Royal Majesties from Edo, Bayelsa, and Ondo States that have flanked you on your left side. And of course, Chiefs of the Kingdom, our brother, the Minister for Niger Delta Affairs, Mr. President, INC, President Emeritus, IYC, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to stand on protocols hitherto established. I want to first and foremost put on record that though I came with our brother and friend, illustrious son of the Niger Delta region, I truly came in my capacity as Deputy Governor of Delta State, representing the interest of the state in what I perceive to be a consultative meeting hosted here by our dear Royal Majesty. Having said so, today actually is a day of sadness and joy. It is a day of mixed feelings. A day of sadness because our dear country actually is in the threshold of self-inclusion. We must take this discussion above rhetorics and face the facts as they stand. We are at the verge of self-inclusion. If you look at the six political zones in this country, other than the Niger Delta region, which we all belong, which our dear brother, the Honorable Minister of Niger Delta Affairs belong, everywhere is in tumult. Talk about the Middle Belt, the Northeast, the Northwest, the Southwest, the Southeast, everywhere is in tumult. So it speaks volume of the singular power that there seems to be a failure of leadership. And my brother, in this my dear brother, my dear, very highly respected brother, in the streets and pubs of the Niger Delta region, the discussion that holds sway is as our brother, the uncommon transformation agenda governor, as he also joined the bandwagon of failed leadership, supports the question. In the public domain, because we cannot explain why an institution as the Nddc, that is a product of an act, is being run in flagrant abuse of the sole powers established in it on the guise of a forensic audit. We are in a representative democracy, and all I know in a representative democracy is that you must listen to the voice of the people. The voice of the people is that there must be a substantive power.
Simple.
There must be a substantive power. For goodness sake, as a government, as at yesterday, the whole of Delta State government was standing on our toes, making calls to every nook and cranny. Your Royal Majesties here seated, they have sleepless time calling their sons and daughters all over the world to ensure that we keep this region at peace. Because in a matter of days, would have kept this quiet region in turmoil. And like I was discussing with you, is that what we want to? Is that what we want to greet and thank Mr. President for appointing one of our own, an highly esteemed and distinguished leader in your capacity? Is that what we wanted to greet him? We're all on our toes. Because like I recorded to you, In 2016, we all knew what happened in this region. To the effect that as a government, we were not able to pay next salaries of our civil servants. It was so bad. And God forbid, us returning to such situation and circumstances. The voice of the people must be listened to. We want a substantive board of the Nddc reinstated as soon as practicable. People, that professors here, medical doctors here, lawyers, of course, you are one. There is no philosophy, there is no phenomenon that forecloses a statutory organization for the sake of an audit. You cannot audit your today and you cannot audit your tomorrow. Forensic audit, in my own opinion, is meant to look at the errors, omissions, and commissions, if any, that it has been committed, not our future. You cannot audit your future. I'm standing here today, cannot audit my future. So the board needs to be put in place. This is the voice of the people. So many have spoken. The collective leadership of the Czech people have spoken. Many a lot of them are here. The collective leadership of the Sopo people have spoken. The collective leadership of the Robo people have spoken. Many, many more others have spoken. The collective leadership of the Just have spoken. And your very good friend, like you told me some few days back, he has also spoken. You told me you are friends. And I spoke with him and he said, you are the best of friends. I don't know what you are using your friendship for. You must use your friendship for ensuring that peace is entrenched in this region. Otherwise, your friendship is not wrong.
This is my message. I want to thank you for...